Hi, beloveds. This is Kathianne Lewis, and I am coming to you from my hotel, the Old Cataract in Aswan, Egypt. And here is my view. And what you don't see is beyond the pool is the Nile. It's just wonderful. I feel blessed to have this life. And I do not take it for granted. What I want to talk about today is how many of us, including me, and I'm thinking it might affect you, how many of us want to have the very best for our family and friends. I mean, life is going well. We really think that life is kind of cool. And we want to share how we got there with others. I remember being a born-again Christian when I was in my teen years, and how my family was atheist or agnostic and really just didn't want to hear how Jesus would save them. I'm so glad they stuck with me. But I sometimes can get as zealot about thinking and how people could change their thinking to change their life as I was when I was a born-again Christian. Although I realized that no one's really lost. No one's going to hell. This is my philosophy. What I realize and within myself is that a God that is love is not going to punish people endlessly for some mistakes they made. That just doesn't equate. But I do think that the way we think and the way we act towards others has an effect on how we can continue to experience life. And that heaven or hell is right here and right now. And sometimes I'm around people and I know that they're in the same old loop and the same old loop and the same old loop and the same old loop, and they complain about it and whine about it and fret over it and suffer through it. And sometimes I just know what would help them just change that loop just a little bit, and then they'd go off and create a new experience for themselves. And I so want to tell them. Oh, what I've realized is that some people just don't want to hear. Some people would rather be right, as in this is the right way to do things, than to be healed. Because oftentimes to really change someone's life experience, they have to change something within themselves, and that can be incredibly painful. It's painful to realize that we are constantly negative, and therefore we can't see the good that's in front of us. It's hard to realize that there's some just tiny little tweaks that would make a huge difference. I do it and I watch other people do it. And I think it's a human condition that we say we want life to change, but we really want life to change to support us in not having to change. And the universe is in a conspiracy for our benefit, which means for our growth and our development. And we can know that. And if we know that and we apply that in our life, well then, hallelujah. But we are not someone else's manager. We do not know their life path. And the thing that has helped me not want to overhelp or overfix someone else is the realization that the God that is the very essence of my being is the essence of their being. And if God knows what to do with me, it knows what to do with them. So I just stay in my own lane and love and bless anybody that wants to have any information from me. And I give it freely, but I don't thrust it on anybody. And I'm a minister. And so try that out. Can you love people even when you watch them flounder, and say something like this: Father, Mother, God within, forgive me for believing that they are somehow stuck. Forgive me for believing that they are somehow thwarted in their development. Let me see them as you see them, and let me be in agreement with the spirit within them that God is doing great things through them. Now, that's an awesome prayer. Talk to you later.
It's in every one of us to be wise. Find your heart, open up both yours. We can all know everything without ever knowing why. It's in every one of us by and by. It's in every one of us to be wise. Find your heart, open up both your eyes. We can all know everything without ever knowing why. It's in every one of us by and by. It's in every one of us. I just remember, it's like I've been sleeping for years. I'm not awake as I can be, but my seeing is better. I can see through the tears. I've been realizing that I bought this ticket, watching only half of the show. But there's scenery and lights and the cast of thousands who all know what I know. And it's good that it's so. It's in every one of us to be wise. Find your heart, open up both your eyes. We can all know everything without ever knowing why. It's in every one of us by and by.